Being a writer means writing for a reader as much as for yourself. That's a crucial step because it does something to your writing, makes it more alert to the craft of language, and means there's something at stake. So, write for a reader. Your job is to arouse their imagination. That leads me to my next point. The imagination loves particulars. Avoid summary and generalization. Imaginative writing depends on evocative detail. A writer is a lover and a student of language. That's your medium, so get to know it intimately. Words are precious. They provide a way in to reality, so don't waste or be careless with words in your writing. Discipline and control is vital, but so is play. Treat your writing as an act of discovery. Find ways of sneaking past your inner censor. Surprise yourself and follow where your imagination leads. Read, read, read. Immerse yourself in the world of books. As a writer, you belong to something far bigger than yourself. Get to know all you can of both the past and the present of the literary tradition, which is nothing less than the history of ideas and the history of the human imagination. As a writer, here and now, you are the life of that inheritance and that calling.